Hi, I'm Shabal Raish and welcome to our home. Today I want to tell you about our family story. So come inside. So I'm excited to introduce you to our home and our lifestyle. Hey kids, come on, it's starting to rain. Let's go inside, grab the ball. Let's go inside. Let's go to mum. Put my hand bent up. Yeah, let's come in. Hi honey.
Hi, how are you?
This is my beautiful wife, Christine. You're gonna get to know her and our seven lovely children. So come inside and get to know us. Honey, do you wanna organize some coffee?
Yeah, let's
have some coffee.
That.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
All right, guys, go inside. I'm born and raised in Sydney, Australia. I was born in Canterbury Hospital, actually, in inner west Sydney. I'm one of six boys. And yeah, I was raised in a good Catholic home. We used to say the rosary in Arabic, Spanish and English growing up. I was born in a suburb called Belfield.
My parents are from Lebanon. They came here and had three children. I'm one of three siblings. We were brought up in the Catholic faith, went to a Melkite church every Sunday, and had a basic understanding of the faith. I probably got most of my education from school, from some very good religion teachers, and got married in 2005 and started life with Charbel.
I loved having my brothers around and my siblings, and I always wanted to give that to my children so they were never alone. So I love having a big family.
We got married with full knowledge of our faith and the openness to life. So we had no intention to have lots of children or to have no children. We were open to whatever God wanted. And
whatever God gives us, we're blessed. We don't even deserve one child, let alone seven. And I'm really blessed to have a big family. And if God blesses us with more, we welcome with open arms whatever God wants. But absolutely love family life and love the idea of our kids close in age and getting along with each other. Every day, my wife and I sit down for a coffee, and it's a very valuable moment in the day for us.
Even amidst the chaos, we stop for those 5, 10, 15 minutes, whatever long we can get, and sit down and sip a coffee and catch up over the day.
So I'd like to invite all of you to come in and join us for a coffee and get to know us a little bit more. So come inside. Coffee is very important in our lives. We've made it a bit of a thing. Every day I try to bring coffee home, or we have 5 minutes out of our day, 5 to 10 minutes. We have a coffee together, and the kids see that, and it's our time, and it's important. I think that we, I guess, understand what the other person's going through and how their day is, and yeah, I really look forward to that time in the day. And the kids want to be a part of it too, so they always want to jump in to the coffee time. So. Yeah, I'd like to call it our coffee time, and I do that as soon as I get home from work, and we do that before we actually get into the busy time of dinner and shower and prayer and getting the kids in PJ. So yeah, we really look forward to that, and we make an effort to make sure that that's priority in our day.
There were many things that attracted me to Charbel, and besides his good looks and physique, I think his faith and his love for God is what ultimately attracted me to him. And I could see that he would make a great husband and a father to our future children.
I think getting to know her, seeing her inner beauty and her devotion to prayer life, and seeing her really wanting to follow our Lord, and that was so inspiring. And when I got to know her, she really is one of the most selfless people I know. She always thinks about other people. She really puts others first, and she's very hospitable and very giving and always joyful. I mean, especially with all the work. I mean, even after marriage, I mean, every day, just to see her smiling all the time, and it's just such a blessing to have her in my life. And she really brings the best out of me because she's thinking about me before herself, and that's very uplifting and very inspiring as well. And so I would have to say Christine's attitude to life, putting God first and others before her, has got to be one of the most attractive attributes she has. The mission for our children is ultimately to get them to heaven. Of course, to get there, we want them to each have a personal encounter with Christ, of course, and His church. And we want them to love God in their own way, find their own vocation. And if they find their calling with God, we are happy. We've done our job. I'd love to make sure that they do God's will. And we'll do the best we can in our capacity to do that and achieve that. So if they've got a calling to the religious life, fantastic. If they've got a calling in the professional world, fantastic. Whatever they do, we just want them to be happy, joy-filled, and doing God's will.
I am the oldest in the family. I have to help my siblings and make sure they don't do the wrong thing. I have lots of jobs, taking out the rubbish, unlocking the chickens in the morning and locking up at night, and unloading the dishwasher. I have to fix my bed and do lots of other things.
Managing a big family is lots of fun. It's chaotic at times, but there are many pleasures in doing the usual mundane tasks of cooking and cleaning and ironing and washing. And the children help a lot. As they get older, the tasks are many, but the children do put a hand in to help.
Michael's our pianist. As much as he says sometimes he doesn't like to practice and doesn't enjoy it, he really does love playing. And when he's on the keyboard, you can tell that he's enjoying it thoroughly. He's a sporty one as well.
Yeah, very good at soccer. Soccer, basketball.
Golf, cricket, you name it, he loves it. So he's an outdoors sort of boy.
Raphael has his own skills as well. He loves fishing.
Loves fishing, loves the outdoors as well.
They've very creative boy.
He's a creative, imaginative type.
Yeah, likes to build things. Elizabeth, she's very particular in her ways, isn't she? She's very great in drawing, colouring in.
She's very maternal as well.
She's mommy. Great. Bringing up the little ones. Gabriel, of course, in his own way, he loves colouring in as well.
Gabriel's got a lot of spunk in his personality, so he's just, he'll find anything to make a joke or make things fun and games and funny for him. And,
yeah.
Yeah, he's just full of silliness and nonsense.
Joseph, he's just always having fun and always joyful. Joseph is the life of the party. He's only 4 years old, but he can really light up a room.
Yeah, he loves to get everyone's attention and I think make people smile. He likes to get everyone to smile and laugh. That's probably his best quality.
That's right. And then this one is Ben. Uh-huh. Benedict. Ben,
he's our dancer.
He's definitely got the skill of dancing. Every time he hears music, this one can move for someone who's not even 2 years old. Wow. To Catherine and Herb, I would say she's the most obedient. She sleeps and she finally, after seven children, we've got a baby that actually goes down awake and sleeps by herself. What a miracle child. She's beautiful, Catherine, only 4 months. I currently run Parousia Media. It's a Catholic ministry, lay-run movement, and we have almost 10 staff, an office in Melbourne, office in Sydney, and it is very busy to travel around Australia and spread the word, and it can be quite difficult balancing work and home. And I have to say, if it wasn't for my wife being in the mission with me, supporting me, I couldn't have done this work. So she really is on board with Parousia Media and helping the mission, and I feel a lot of the things that we've done as a ministry, it's thanks to my wife's support and my wife's prayers and my wife's blessing as well, because if she's not behind the decisions, then, you know, we could have been a lot different.
Parousia started many years ago, and originally it was a lot of time dedicated by Charbel and myself when we only had a few children. As time has passed, the business has grown and it has required more help, which I haven't been able to afford to give him.
Thank God we're in this together as a family. And one day I hope the children, when they grow up, they'll join in the ministry to spread the gospel of Jesus Christ to this country and beyond. So I absolutely love doing my work. I feel it's a vocation within a vocation. So yes, the vocation to marriage and parenting. And then within that, my career is also a mini vocation that Parousia Media is such a fulfilling job, and I have to say I love doing that. It doesn't feel like work because I feel like I have a unity of life where my work and my personal life is one, because it doesn't feel like work. It's a ministry, it's a mission.
When he's out on his work within the ministry, where the children step up a little bit and take over a lot of the chores that perhaps Jabba would need to do, and we definitely pray for him when he's travelling and pray for the ministry, because and the children know what Dad does. They know that he's spreading the word of God, and so when he's absent, they know he's doing a really good deed, and they're quite pleased with that. There have been many difficult situations that we've come across. One, and probably most for most big families, would be the financial.
I actually still wasn't working full-time. I was working only part-time, finishing a university degree, because I came out of the seminary, actually. And my wife was the breadwinner in the early years of the marriage.
There was a time where I couldn't even afford groceries. Went to the grocery shop and had to calculate with a calculator every item that went into the basket to make sure I didn't, you know, exceed the budget that we had. Anyway, over time, you know, and with trust, we overcame that.
Somehow God provided, and I managed to get more hours at work, got into teaching for the first time, and then finally got my full-time job, and we managed. And it sort of happened again with the fourth child, and then the fifth child, it got tight again, and then somehow God opened the way for us. I can't describe it, but right until after the child was born, God showed a way. Either my pay increased, or I got more hours. In the early years in the gym, I was doing gym work, then I was doing teaching. And then, of course, a big one was with the question with our ministry, Parousia Media. We were facing the big decision of giving up the mission because we couldn't provide the finances for it, as my teaching salary was paying both a family expense and the ministry. And my wife and I prayed about it, and we said, look, maybe God has asked enough of us there, and we need to move on and just focus on the family and go back to teaching full time.
The support that I gave Charbel was to encourage him to continue in his ministry, even though it wasn't paying the bills or things like that, and that if God didn't will it, then, you know, it would come to a close naturally. So we supported each other in that sense, that we didn't give up and didn't think, oh, well, that's it. We need to find a proper job or what have you. He did pick up a bit more teaching hours, and that helped support the family.
Somehow God provided, and I met who is now Kevin in our life, who who was introduced to me via Scott Hahn. So Scott Hahn told him about me, and he came in and saw the work and wanted to be involved, and somehow said Parousia Media needs to be full-time, and we've learned to appreciate everything in life, and thank God. So I do remember financially, every time we had a child, it got very difficult. But my wife has been very supportive in these difficult times. She reminded me to trust in God. Sometimes when I doubted, she would be there to remind me that God's with us. Don't worry, trust. We value prayer life very much in our family. We want to create as many opportunities for prayer in our family as possible. Some of the things we do, if we're driving to church or to any other place, we would say a morning offering in the car. Obviously, grace before meals. Angelus is a big thing in our family. So at midday, we say the Angelus. And then at 3 o'clock, we say the 3 o'clock Divine Mercy prayer. Sometimes we say the chaplet, but not all the time. And then, of course, at night we attempt to say the rosary. We get a few done in the week, but not every day, but we do our best to get the rosary done. And then, of course, night prayer, where we invoke the saints of each child, and each child has a first name and a middle name, and we invoke all of those saints. And then we do an examination of conscience, just for 30 seconds, and we think of our day, ask God for the blessings and all the things we've done wrong, and say an act of contrition.
It's probably the best part, because it's when the kids are so quiet.
Yeah.
You find as soon as we say examination of conscience, they all know to kneel down and think about their day, the good and the bad. And there's that just that brief moment of silence. Very yes. Brief, but it's silence nonetheless.
Yeah, we call for prayer position at nighttime, and they all line up from oldest to youngest, and we say those prayers, and then at night I bless them. So we have a little water fountain, and I bless each child. I say Hail Mary for them, and then I ask God to bless them and give them good dreams and not bad dreams.
They've taken so much to the blessing. They appreciate it so much that even when we leave home or we're going somewhere, we're leaving them behind to be babysat or what have you. The youngest ones mainly will come and bless us and tell us have a safe trip there and a safe trip back. And it's just so sweet. But they obviously appreciate what Dad does and these little, I don't know if they're rituals or little practices that will probably remain with them till their adulthood.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, it's great. If we ever forget, make sure they remind us.
They do, they remind us. They won't go to bed without a blessing.
And we also, just during the week, wherever we can, there's catechism classes once a week. The Catechesis of the Good Shepherd is our children go to that. Once they're 3 years old, up until 12, they have different lessons. And you know, we have sessions from, is it 3 to 6, then 6 till 9, 9 till 12?
Yeah, so each child goes to one of these sessions during the week. There's some children on Monday, some on Tuesday, and some on a Friday. And the most beautiful part is the moment of silence, because it's called the atrium. And when they enter it, it's between them and the Holy Spirit. And so the Holy Spirit guides them in their work and their choices and what they decide to do that day. And often they will pick something about the Good Shepherd or something about the mustard seed, and they do a little story, and then they go off and do an activity or a work. Yeah.
Oh, it's fantastic. An hour and a half a week, these children are doing this, and everything is in a miniature format according to the Montessori method, but applied to the Catholic faith. And yeah, it's just such a special thing to see. I've learned a lot just watching them.
The children are happier. The family works a little bit differently, and everyone's just a bit more peaceful. The graces are there, so it's certainly worth persevering and going, even though at times we don't want to get out of bed in the morning, or it's too cold, or someone's sick, or whatever the excuse might be. It's certainly, we reap the rewards when we do go.
I think it's a more joyful family than other families, because we're homeschooled and my mum teaches us about the Catholic faith, doesn't let us go to school and like learn different things. She lets us play outside at midday and lets us play.
A major goal or dream of ours for our family is to bring up all our children in a virtuous manner, that they can be the best human beings they can be, best children of God they can be, selfless, you know, living charitable lives where they're helping people, thinking of others first, obviously putting God first, others, and then themselves last. And so, yeah, we don't want selfish kids. We don't want to teach them to be sneaky. We want them to be truthful, honest, hardworking, you know, and helpful to the society as a whole. And from there, they can be future, whatever they want to be.
Yeah, whatever vocation they choose,
yeah,
as long as they fulfill it to the best of their ability in according to God's will, I think, is what we really want. So ultimately, we want them to choose right from wrong.
Yeah.
Be moral, sound, virtuous children or adults at that stage.
Stand up on their own feet.
And be able to bring along all the souls possible with them to heaven. So not just themselves or their salvation, but the salvation of everyone that they meet.
Yeah.
Which is pretty much what Daddy does for work.
Yeah, the idea of they can actually, you know, stand up in this society, in this culture, and be the light to the world. And if each of our children can do that and choose right from wrong, that's a blessing. That's a job well done. So we really hope that all of them can be good examples and role models for their friends and their peers, and not be just followers, but actual go against the tide and be a light to the world and bring the good news to all they meet, and hopefully their friends and colleagues and fam and relatives can see their actions and example, and you know, yeah, be inspired. So yeah, we want them to be joyful. We're joyful all the time because there's always so many funny things that happen on a daily basis.
Yes.
You can't predict what's going to happen around the corner. Each one of our children are unique. Each one of them have their own character.
Own personality and their own quirkiness. And that brings a lot of life to the family. I think the joy comes from every child contributing to our family. And I always tell the kids we're a team. So for any family out there, you know, having lots of children is a true blessing. And a blessing to each other, to the siblings themselves.
Yeah. We knew from the beginning it was never going to be easy, and we're not saying it's easy, it's very difficult, but it is so fulfilling. And that's the message we would say is really...
Persevere.
Persevere. From one joyfully big family to all of you, we hope that all of you will have joyfully big families as well. God bless you.
God bless.
World Television is coming to Australia. This is a great gift. It's been gifted to many parts of the world, and now it's our Australian turn to receive it with open arms. I welcome it, I bless it. It's going to really support family life, married life, youth, give us a resource that we know that we need, really helping, it's great help in these areas. May Almighty God bless this new resource coming to our land. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.